I would say the basic philosophy from preschool on up, and this is a written statement in our gym, is to build the self-esteem of every child, regardless of age, size, color, what have you. And, you know, if you really just hang on to that, it helps you in your everyday coaching when you're struggling or whatever. And as an elite coach, my philosophy is to help them reach their goals. It's important to me to know where they're headed, because you have some elites that want to be international, some that want to be national, some that, all different types. And I want to know what they want, because then whenever there's a controversy, you can say to them, let's look at what your goal is, and is this something that's going to lead us towards that or away from it? So I think it's important to me to know where each one of my athletes is headed. Our daily routine begins on Monday, the beginning of the week. That's when we kind of kick off what's going to happen for the week. And we start off with a schedule that I spend a lot of time on, because I feel like the planning is a big part of success, because important ingredients are not left out when you plan. So I sit down every Saturday or Sunday and I plan my next week based on the good and the bad of the week before. I hand it to the girls, and after they finish their warm-up, we do a half an hour warm-up every time we train, and the warm-up includes a cardiovascular, then into a little section of conditioning, and then into a little section of stretching. And this is and really, when you design a warm-up, those are the three ingredients that I feel are necessary to begin workout. And every now and then we change the warm-up. So they do this for half an hour, and at the end of that they get their workout for the week. And we kind of discuss any areas that they don't understand, that, because I make it different. I make it different all the time. We have a basic format, which I'll go over when we go into the events. A basic format, but within the format, I make changes. And they look forward to getting this workout to see what's going to happen the next weekend versus, well, here we go again, you know. So it helps. Thank you.
forward to come in and walk. So as soon as she gets done warming, it's like we'll set up a walk for her.
Pull your arms back a little bit further. Okay. That's good. Are you gripping pretty much with that hand? You have to be gripping some. I mean, to be able to carry your body up that thing. Okay, you're on. Shouldn't you be stretching? Shoulders.
How's that dough? I'm staying.
Your butt, do that again. I'll see this part back here. I don't think you do.
Thank you.
have a little jar, and it's geared towards really life skills. Some of them are geared towards motivational things, you know, believe and succeed, that type of thing. Some of them are just people skills. Gossip is like the tongue on the shoe, it's too loose or something like that. You know, just different things about how to be a better person. And each day, with the elites, now at the different levels in our program do it a little bit differently. They have the flexibility to do this however they choose. I've asked them to do it, but I don't push it a whole lot. My kids that I have, I only coach 3 kids right now, we all can relate on certain topics. We all have a similar belief in God, and we, you know, so there's a lot of scripture verses sometimes in there. And so each person pulls out of the jar, and they read it, and they explain it. And the purpose of the explanation is public speaking skills. At the level that Amanda, JC, and Robin are at, there are many opportunities where they have to speak in front of a camera. And at the beginning, I know with JC, she was very uncomfortable, and there was a lot of and so that's because when has she ever had to speak? And so I feel like the more they learn to express their feelings, nothing an interviewer likes more is when somebody's real. You know, they don't like the candid same answers. So I'm trying to teach the kids to speak from their heart, and these sayings are very heart-filled sayings, so it kind of forces that without them really even realizing what they do. And then what's really been fun lately is we take the sayings and we give them to people that we think might need that saying for the day, or sometimes they just put it in their gym bag if they wanted to keep it themselves. And the thing that I find is I learn from them every day, and when my other coaches do it with their athletes, they learn. So the bottom line is everybody's becoming a better person, which creates a better environment. Okay, Robin, you can go first.
Okay. Worry is not empty tomorrow of its sorrow. It empties today of its strength.
Okay, so read the beat. What was the first part?
Worry does not empty tomorrow of its sorrow.
Worry does not empty tomorrow of its sorrow.
So it's kind of like, if you're worried about something, let's quit worrying about it today.
Like, what was the last part of it?
It empties today of its strength. Don't worry about what's going to happen tomorrow, because it'll just ruin today instead of just waiting.
Dealing with today.
Mine kind of goes with that. Therefore, do not worry about tomorrow, for tomorrow will worry about itself. Each day has enough trouble of its own.
That needs to go on Connie's desk. Okay, Jace?
There is a world of difference between knowing the Word of God and knowing the God of the Word.
That's challenging. Do you need help?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, the first part says that there are a lot of people that know the Word of God, meaning they go to church every Sunday and they hear the Word of God. But then the real part of it is do you know God? So like, you can go to church every single week, or you could participate in a Bible study and do whatever, and you can never know God if you don't have a personal relationship. And so that's what the last part, read the last sentence again.
Knowing the God of the Word.
Knowing the God of the Word, you understand?
Mm-hmm.
So the God that's in the Bible, do you really know that person? Okay, do you understand?
Mm-hmm.
All right, a gossiper, this is kind of cute. A gossiper is like an old shoe. Its tongue never stays in place. That just means that a gossiper talks all the time and their tongue is always going.
Their tongue slips like the tongue
in your shoe as your shoe gets older. All right, we're going to do